What number sets does the number 8 belong to? Now, before even answering that question, let's just think about the different number sets there are. There are the real numbers. The real numbers. And these are literally all of the numbers we've been dealing with to date. When we go to more advanced topics, you'll learn that there are such things as imaginary and complex numbers, or at least in the mathematical sense, they exist. But for now, real numbers are essentially everything that we know of on the number line. So if I were to draw the number line right here, a real number can be represented as any point on this number line, or it's the set of all of the points on this number line. If you just keep going in the positive direction, and you just keep going in the negative direction, it's all of these points, and it includes numbers like pi, where their decimal representation is 3.14159. It just keeps repeating on and on and on. Never, it cannot be represented as a fraction or as a rational expression. It just is this decimal expansion that just keeps goes on and on and on and on. Square root of 2 is another one that is also a real, but everything else is also. So real is kind of the broadest set of numbers we've been dealing with. Now, if we want to be a little bit more restrictive, we get to rational numbers. And the best way to think about rational, there's two ways to think about it. These are numbers that can be expressed as, you could say, as a rational expression or as a fraction. So for example, negative 1 is a rational number because negative 1 could be written as negative 1 over 1. 0 is a rational number. It can be expressed as 0 over anything. It could be 0 over 10. Doesn't have to be. 2 is a rational number. 1/2 is a rational number. All of these are rational numbers. What aren't rational numbers are numbers like square root of 2 or 3.14 or pi or e. These numbers that cannot be represented as a fraction. So you can imagine that the rational numbers, it's kind of like the set of real numbers. Maybe I write it like this. It's the set of real numbers minus if you were to take out irrational numbers. Take out irrational numbers, and these are like, so for example, we have things like pi, e. These are actual numbers, 3.1415. E is, between 2 and 3, square root of 2. We can go on and on and on. There's an infinite number of irrational numbers. So it's a little abstract, but anything that can be represented as a fraction, you definitely know is rational. Now, if we want to get a little bit more restrictive than that, if we just want to deal with the numbers that aren't fractions in the traditional sense, that are, I guess we could use the word whole numbers, although we want to be careful with that word, because that could also be considered a number set. If we're thinking about just the 4, the 3, the 2, all of the kind of the I guess, whole numbers, then we're talking about the integers. So these are, we could just go from the negative direction, maybe negative 2, negative 1, then 0, then we get 1, 2, 3. I think you get the idea. It's all of the positive and negative whole numbers, and it includes zeros. So if you were to do the integers on this line, it would be everything that I'm doing in orange. Now, there's two other sets that are subsets of integers, depending on the interpretation you look at. So sometimes you'll hear people say whole numbers. And this is a bit of an ambiguous statement, because sometimes when people say whole numbers, they're referring to integers. Sometimes when they're referring to whole numbers, they're referring to non-negative integers, so 0, 1, 2, 3. Sometimes they're referring to just positive integers, so 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth. So this is a little bit ambiguous. I've seen it used in all of those different ways. But if someone says a whole number, I generally think of non-negative numbers. It's ambiguous, but for our purposes, let's think of it as 0, 1, 2, so on and so forth. Now, the last one to consider is natural numbers. And once again, this one is also ambiguous. Natural numbers. And the reason why it's called natural numbers is these are numbers that you would actually encounter if you were to either try to order things or actually count things in nature. So it definitely, this is also ambiguous. But it definitely excludes negative numbers. And so if it definitely excludes negative numbers, you're just like, why is it ambiguous? Well, it's ambiguous whether it includes 0. So Sometimes 0 is natural, so 0 may or may not be natural, depending on the context. May or may not be natural. Now, let's answer our actual question. What number sets does 8 belong to? Well, 8 definitely belongs to the real numbers. It is on the number line. It is definitely a rational number. We can express it as 8 over 1, or 16 over 2, or even, you know, negative 8 over negative 1. I mean, you could actually have an infinite number of ways to express it as a fraction. So it's definitely a rational number. It's definitely an integer. It's a whole number. It's definitely an integer. It is a whole number. I mean, we're ambiguous what to include in whole numbers, but positive 8 is unambiguously a whole number. It's definitely included. And it's unambiguously a natural number. If I go out and count trees, I can count 8 trees. So it is a positive, you know, if the number was 0, I'd be like, well, depending on who you talk to, it might be a natural number. But 8 definitely is a natural number. So it's a part of all of these number sets.